Okay, great. Thank you so much to everyone, and thank you so much, Dr. Balam and Dr. Srinivas, for the introductory speech. And thanks a lot, Sharmita, for giving me the opportunity to participate in this international webinar as for the clear introduction of as well. So, as Sharmita has pointed out, that today I'm going to talk about orange plus sweet potato. It's a very unique crop and it has a lot of benefits, and we have learned quite a lot about this particular crop. In African continent, it's not only one country, we have worked across more than 15 countries across the African continent. We have gained a lot of experience from this particular crop. So today I'm going to talk about what we learned from this crop and how it can be this crop in India. So, before I start, I would like to just give you a background about our office, International Potato Center, who we are, and then I will give you the major wisdom of it. So, International Potato Center is a research for development organization with a focus on potatoes, potato, and adding roots and tubers. We are headquartered in Lima, Peru. It has a research presence in more than 20 countries across the globe. So I would put it as a major continent, Africa, Asia, Latin America. But we also have our a huge presence in India. And then we also have across African countries. The SIC is a CGIAR research center. The CAR is a global research partnership for the food secure future. The science is carried out by 50 research centers in close collaboration with hundreds of partners across the globe. So the CGR stands for Consultative Group on International Agriculture Research. So it is headquartered in Italy, Rome. Our major mission is a healthy and inclusive, resilient world through root and tuber system. Our mission is to deliver innovative science-based treatment to enhance access to affordable, nutritious food, foster inclusive, sustainable business and employment growth, and drive the climate resilience of the root and tubers agri-food system. So, this is the background about our international research organization. So, as I said, we are an international research institute and work across the globe. We have been supported by various donors. The donors' money coming from different developed nations who is interested to improve the livelihood of smallholders across developing and underdeveloping countries. So today I'm going to talk about sweet potatoes. website and online. And it requires a right call of 7,000 are considered to be the most suitable irrigation facilities required. And there are many varieties, and this particular crop matured much earlier. This means this crop requires only 4 months for you to get the outcome. It's not a really long crop. Now we are even searching to find out how best this crop can be put in the spring. And it is highly adaptable and tolerant to high temperature and low soil fertility and drought area. It's a climate resilient crop. Is that we have got as a introductory speech that we have highlighted that the climate change is a serious issue. It is more visible nowadays, and also the nutrition and also the various pests. So this crop plays a very important role for the climate resilience model and I can take that in the later slide. And this sweet potato particular variety can grow in the north of several crops. So in a dry area, don't have really any other crop that cannot be grown in that area. This crop can be grown, but it can be stored in the sand for the consumption purpose as well as to generate the seed to replant for the next season. So if you are having a long, prolonged dry season, this crop can play a very important role, not only as just planting the crop, but it also plays a very food security crop and also the nutritional crop. So how about this crop as a sorry for that technical glitch. You managed to see this slide? No.
Yeah.
So
okay, great.
So, let me, because the moment I put in presentation mode, it looks you're not able to see that. Are you able to see the presentation mode now?
Yeah.
So awesome. As I said that it is a very friendly and climate resilient crop, and it has a challenge in terms of weaving infestations. It depends when the soil gets cracked and the sweet potato will have a problem on weaving. So the average yield in sub-Saharan African continent will have 8 to 9 tons per hectare, and whereas the potential yield that goes up to 40 tons per hectare. So you might have seen the potential that African continent that we had. So last 10 years of our interventions, we have improved from average yield from 8 to 9 tons to 18.5 tons in Sub-Saharan Africa. So in Sub-Saharan Africa, I will say that sweet potato is one of the oldest crops, more than 5,000 years old, but So it's about per capita is about 80 kg per capita consumed annually. And then one of the more largest producers of sweet potato is located in sub-Saharan Africa. So number one is China. China is leading in many crop as a number one. In fact, the vegetable producers also, they are standing number one. So similarly here, sweet potato of Tanzania and Nigeria is a lead producers in the world. But if you look at in terms of their yield level, China is able to produce more than 30 tons per hectare. Whereas sub-Saharan Africa, we are still struggling to reach the potential level. So if you look at in terms of area under sweet potato, African continent is having much more than China. So why we are talking about this particular crop? If you look at in sub-Saharan Africa agricultural status right now, globally, before getting into sub-Saharan, I like to just say how important is malnutrition is concerned. Globally, 2 billion preschool children and 19 million children are affected by vitamin A deficiency. Malnutrition comes majorly due to lack of vitamin A deficiency. So in sub-Saharan itself, more than 48% of children under 5 suffers vitamin A deficiency. So half of the children, they are suffering because of vitamin A deficiency. And this might create a lot of problems. Visual impairment, blindness, there's a significant increase in the risk of illness and even death. So orange plus sweet potato is basically within the sweet potato, it's a special variety. It looks very orange color inside the sweet potato. So we call it orange fleshed sweet potato. It provides solution to vitamin A deficiency. So there are a lot of projects in sub-Saharan Africa and create a lot of awareness about this particular crop to ensure that people consume this crop quite a lot so that they will have a sufficient vitamin.